Hi, welcome to automationtesting.in. Please hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications. In this video, we will see handling web tables. As part of this, we will see handling web tables, find multiple elements, helper methods to write or to handle web tables, or double click and then right click. Okay, for this, first go to the application. You see, this is the web table, it's a separate tab. So here we will see the data in the form of table. And a web page, you have a table, that is the reason it's called web table. So I have to handle this one. I have 10 rows here. So my requirement is whether this email ID is having pragya@gmail.com. So I register some people. So after registering, I need to verify whether the particular email ID is in this table or not. So I need to find all the emails, whether this contains this one or not. And the same way, I want to edit a particular row, a record. So for this, I have a here what? Pencil icon. When I double click this, you see this, it becomes editable. Okay. I want to do this particular row. I don't know, this Pragya may be in the first row, second row, third row, fourth row, tenth row, I don't know. When you keep adding, it may move to some other place. But my logic should be, if it is moving to some other place, even then also the logic which I am writing should work. So that kind of logic I have to work. And here it is double click, and this is right click in the dustbin symbol. When I say right click, you see delete and cancel will get. So how to perform delete and double click, sorry, right click and double click, and how to handle this web table. Okay. For this is very important, and this is one of the interview questions you will definitely face 99.9%. Because that is the reason you need to be cautious while working with the web tables. Okay, and so first we'll see how to get all these email IDs, and then we'll move one by one. So first go to Eclipse. Create a class handling web table, and I'll copy paste the same code from here. And this is webtable.html. This is web table, and it is taking bit time to load the data. So I'll use thread.sleep 5 seconds. That's fine. Now, first one I need to do, I need to get all email IDs. So when I inspect, so it's very critical web table. If you try to write CSS or XPath for this, you'll become master in that to write XPath and CSS. Please try all those things. So I'm not wasting the time. I already captured this CSS selectors, everything. So I'll use here. You see that the CSS selector finding 1 of 10 means 10 elements, and you observe here it is highlighting one by one. You see the mail IDs, it is highlighting. So it is finding all the email IDs. So I'll take this, I go back to this one. What I'll do, this is list of web element. We already seen that, but even though all emails is equals driver dot find elements by dot CSS selector, I need to give this CSS selector. Okay. Now I need to import this java.util, and then from Selenium. Okay. So now I need to verify whether pragya@gmail.com is in this or not. For the what I'll do, first I need to get the strings. All these are comes in the form of web element, right? So everything is a web element. Pragya@gmail.com is coming form of web element, this is also web element, this is also web, each and every email is a web element. So I'll convert this into strings. List of string emails, otherwise email IDs. Okay, so new array list of string. So I am creating one dummy empty array list. So now what I'll do, I will loop through these web elements and I'll add each element to this list. How I'll do? For each, I'll take a web element and this is all email IDs. So I'll say email ID. I'm taking each and every element one by one from this list to this web element. So here what I'll do, this is a list, this list dot add, what I'm adding, email ID dot get text. Okay, so while loop through, while looping, I'm adding each and every web element text into this list of strings. Now this list contains all the web element strings. Now I have string values, pregnant@gmail.com, sebas@email.com, something like that. Okay, now this list contains all the email IDs. From all the web elements, I have taken the text and I am adding this to this list. So now what I'll do, if email IDs dot, this is the one, right? Dot contains, what it contains, what I'm expecting, that email ID is out, I'll say test pass. In the same way, I want to print, while adding I will print the email IDs also. So here I'm adding, right? Okay, let it be. Control chat. After that, I'll print those. For each string from this email IDs, I'll say email is out email. I'm just printing all the email IDs. I'm looping through this list and I'm printing email. And the same way, I'll take this Pragya. If the list contains this, pass. Else, is out. Test fail. Okay. Before failing the test, what I'll do, is out. I'm just giving separation to see that output perfectly. So now what I'll do, I'll run this. So I'll close the browser. You see that? It printed all the email IDs and after that I'm getting test pass. The reason is, the entire list contains this pragya@gmail.com. Okay. After this, what I'll do, I'll take one more thread.sleep and here driver.quit. Instead of me quitting the browser, it will automatically quit. Now what I'll do, I'll say pragya1. Okay. Pragya1, and I'll run the same thing again. We'll see, this time it has to fail. And after 10 seconds, so after 5 seconds, it will close the browser. 5 seconds to load this. After this, after performing all these actions, after 5 seconds, it will quit the browser. We'll wait for that. You see that? Now this is test fail. The reason is Pragya 1 is not there. Okay? Now we are able to find all the find multiple elements. You see that I am finding all the multiple elements. I am storing in the list and I am printing all these things. I am verifying particular string is there in the list or not. Okay, the first concept is done. Now I give particular email ID or phone number. In this entire web table, email ID and phone numbers are unique, but as is a dummy web table, it broke, it seems. It is accepting some, you see, duplicate values, but no problem. We'll take some unique phone number and we'll try to this, otherwise we'll take some unique email ID. Okay, now what I'll do, I want to edit particular email ID record. So I want to double click on this. Okay, so how to do that? Whether it may be this email ID or Seba's email ID, whatever it may be. When I provide this email ID, it has to go to that particular row and it has to click this one, particular edit icon. Okay, for that, what we'll do, first we'll try to find this icon. You see that when I give this icon is highlighting. When I say I, you see that this icon is highlighting. You see that well, remove this. You see that it is highlighting first row. In the first row, we have one more div. And inside that, I have div colon nth child of 6. You see that? It is highlighting 6. The reason is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th column. In the first row, 6th column, inside this, I have one of the class called dot fa hyphen pencil. You see that I am taking this class fa pencil. Okay, this is highlighting this one. So when I take this, I'll go back to my Eclipse. First, what I'll do after this, first I'll store this in a string desired pencil icon is equals to, as it's a very big, so I'm storing in a thing. Now what I need to do, web element pencil symbol is equals to driver dot find element by dot CSS selector. What is that CSS selector? Desired pencil icon. Right, now I found this particular web element, means this icon, and I'm hard coding first row, sixth column, all these things. I'm assuming Pragya is in first row. First we'll see normally, then we'll make it unique logic. Okay. Now, I need to do double click, right? How to do double click? For that, we have one of the classes. Actions is a class. You see the actions is a class from org.openq.selenium.interactions. Action equals to new actions. You need to pass the driver instance to this. Then action dot, you have move to element. Which element? Pencil symbol dot double click. Okay. And then when you say action class, you need to do build dot perform. Okay, whenever you say action class, build.perform means this chain of actions is building and performing. Okay, this is what, right? I am found in the pencil icon and I am double clicking on this. Okay, now I'll try to run this. First we'll see normal way and then we'll see unique logic. You see that it double clicked on that, that is the reason it became editable. After that you can edit whatever you want. Okay, now we'll take one more string, desired delete icon, and what is that? I already captured this, the same thing, control, I'll paste here, and here trash, this is the one, find the dustbin symbol or delete symbol or icon, whatever you call. Okay, I'll copy this, I'll go to the application and I'll paste here. You see that it is finding this icon. You see that when I hover on that, it's finding there. Okay, so what I'll do, and then web element delete symbol is equals to driver dot find element by dot CSS selector desired delete icon. Okay, now I need to do right click here. Okay, this is right click action. In the same way, what I'll do, I'll comment this code. The reason is, once it click on edit icon, it will not see the delete icon. Okay, that is the reason I am commenting this code. Otherwise we'll do one thing. From here we'll comment. Okay, now the same way, actions, action equals to new actions of driver, and then action dot, you have context click. You see that context click, and you need to mention that what is that dot build dot perform. I think it should work. The right click means context click. So now we'll give a try. Just finding that element, I am using that actions class, and I'm directly using the method which is available in the actions class. After 5 seconds, it has to work. You see that it right clicked. That is the reason I'm able to see these things. Okay, it closed. So you can do one more thing. The same way what we did here, action dot move to element delete symbol dot context click dot build dot perform. You can directly context click is a overloaded method. It is accepting a web element, otherwise a normal method without any parameters. So here also you have the same thing, action dot directly double click. I'll show you here, action dot. You see that double click, right? You have both the ways for context click and double click. Here I am showing move to element, here I showed directly done. And you can see something like this also. We'll give it a try, this one also. Then you'll come to know that there are two ways. If one is not working, you can try with another one. It purely depends on the application. If it is not working, you have to use these all permutations and combinations. You have to make it work. You see that it is right click, and then after 5 seconds it will close the browser. Yeah, it's working perfectly. Now I am hard coding here. That right, go to the first row, Okay, go to the sixth column and go to that particular pencil icon or delete icon. Okay. But this logic will never, will always not work. Here the reason is, the first row, now it is Pragya. Tomorrow if I add some more people, Pragya may go to 5th location or 6th location or 10th location, I don't know. It will keep updating the first one. But I don't want something like that. I want, when I provide email ID, it has to tell me in which row it is. When I provide email ID, it has to tell me in which row it is. Okay, that logic I need to build. Okay, so we'll go there. I'll comment this one also. I don't need this for some time. So after test fail, what I'll write here, I need to find the position of that particular email ID. Okay, so int position, I'm taking one dummy variable, I'm initializing as 0 for, I have all the web elements right here, all the emails. Okay, I'll take all emails here, web element, all emails. Did I use an email somewhere? I use it here. I'll do one thing. Email ID and email ID. Then you will not confuse. Okay, here I used. Anyhow, the scope of this one will be here only. So no problem. We'll see if you have any issues, then we'll see. Web element email from all emails. When I'm looping through, if email dot get text dot equals, okay, the desired email ID. When I found the email ID which I'm finding, I'll break the loop. Okay, what is that mail ID? Pragya. Suppose first I'll take Pragya and I'll remove this one. Okay, when I'm looping through, one by one I'm taking, first one I'm taking, it's get text is equals to Pragya, and I'm checking. Okay, the first position I'm getting, so it will break here only. Okay, but before checking this, what I'll do, I'll take this position here and I'll do plus plus, means it will increment to 1. Okay, now you need to understand the logic, right? The position I have taken 0 initially. When it comes to the inside this position, 0 plus plus means it will become 1. Now the position value is 1. Now I'm checking email.getText is equals to Pragya. Yes, it is. Then it will break. Now position value is 1. So the Pragya is in first position. Okay, now what I'll do, I'll change it to sebas@email.com. Okay, Sebas. Now what will happen when you go to the application, 1, 2, 3 in the third position. Okay, first what it will do, it will make position 1 and it will search email.getText. First I will get Pragya. Pragya equals to Sebas? No. Then it will not go inside this. Then it will take second one, it will put here. And then now the position is 1. 1 plus plus, it will become 2. And that email.getText, what is that, some blah blah is there. That equals to Sebas? No. No, it will not go inside this. Again, it will take third element, it will put inside this. Now 2 plus plus, the position is 2. 2 plus plus, it will become 3. And that third web element dot get text is equals to Sebas? Yes. Then it will go inside this, it will break. Now position value is 3 and my Sebas is in third position. 1, 2, 3. Now I found position of particular email ID by using this much of code, this logic. Okay. Now what I'll do, Now instead of my desired position, I'll change this to its desired position. What I'll do? I don't know this is 1, 2, 3 or 4, I don't know. Right. I hard-coded first row, but this time I don't know. That is the reason what I'll do. This one will be replaced with this position. So what I'll do, I'll append this. Close. Plus. You see that? Now I'm forming this desired pencil icon element. Which row, I don't know. I cannot hard code. I don't know in which position it is. But I found this position here by using this logic. What is the row of this sebas@email.com? That position I'm replacing here. If tomorrow if I change to Pragya, Pragya is the one, that position will be one. This is one. Now it is three. I made it very dynamic. Right, now I made it very dynamic. Now I'll run this. According to the position, it will double click on that. Now it has to double click for Sebas. You see that? It double clicked for Sebas and it will close. Fine. Now what I'll do? I'll take this one and I'll replace here. Now it has to click on the first position. Right, I'll give a try. Now I'm not telling that go to which row, that row, this row. I'm just telling edit this email ID row. That's it. It is calculating the row and it is working itself by using that logic what we have written. You see that? This time it clicked the first position. Now I'll take something else. I'll take, these are all, okay, I'll take anyone. The first occurrence it will work. Okay, when it is equal, it will go inside that and it will work. Control V, Control S, and I'll run. Now it has to click. You see that? It clicked this one. It one, this one, and this one are duplicate even though the first occurrence. Whenever it finds, it will go inside that and it will break. Okay? Now I'm not hard coding. I created a logic here. Now you can do the same thing here also. Div in child of position. Now I'll comment this. Now I'll uncomment this. Right. And for this email ID, it has to right click. Wait for 5 seconds and it will double right click. You see that? It is right clicking for this element by taking this email ID. Right. Working perfectly. Now we have built the logic. This logic is important that if somebody asks how to do, then it is very easy. Right, I'm using CSS select. Okay, now I have so many tables and I want to perform the same action for multiple times. So I have to write this much logic, okay, and I have to write this much logic. Means at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 13 lines of code I have to write. It's not a best practice. Right, for this what we'll do, we'll create a method, helper method, public static void edit table row using email. Okay, and it will accept, what it will accept, you just provide your email, string email. Okay, now I'll move it, now I will move everything to this. Okay, I need to get this list first. I need to get that list here, and the driver, you see that this driver instance I need, I'll move the driver to the class level, this web driver to this class level, and it should be static, as I'm using inside the static method. Okay, now I'll move to this logic, I'll copy paste this logic. I'll explain you once I did all these things. Why I'm getting this error? Duplicate. Where it is matching? Where it is matching? Okay, I'll do email one. Then email one dot get text. No problem. Now then, this is editing, right? Editing means this logic I need. Right. This logic I need. That's it. I have written the logic to edit the table row. So this, I hard coded all these things. Okay, I know I have only one this table. These things will never change. So this, instead of this one, what I'll do? I'll do email. This email I am passing using this method. Whenever I call this method using this email, that will be replaced here, and it will get the position, and it will replace the position, and it will do double click. Okay, in the same way we'll write the delete also. Okay, we'll write the delete also. Delete table row using email ID, and the logic is this one. After for loop, I'll place this. Okay, the same thing, I'm getting the position, this email, and I'm getting the, using this, you know, this position using this email, and I'm replacing here, and I'm performing the same action. So now what I'll do, I'll comment this code also. I don't need all these things. Now instead of writing this much code, and I don't need this position also, okay, I am not using all this code, but what I'll do, I'll call the method edit table row using email ID. I'll provide this email ID, control C, control V. That's it. These are all to just print, right? Even I don't need all these things, but let it be. This single line is enough. Whenever I need, use this method, provide your email ID. Don't write this logic again and again. Just keep a helper method, this method. Maybe in the same class, maybe in other classes, when you create a framework, you will move to this other class, but as part of this class, I'm just seeing here. Okay. Now if I run this, it has to edit, double click on that particular row. You see that? It is double clicked, right? Now I'll take Pragya. I'll just change this mail ID, that's it. Now I'll run again. It should be for the first row. I'm just mentioning, you see that? I'm just mentioning this mail ID, go and edit, that's it. The method is taking care of all these things. Now I'll comment this. I'll use delete. Right. That's it. Delete this for this mail ID. Now it will right click for the, you see that first row Pragya, it right click by that email ID. Now I'll change that email ID to Sebas. Okay, now we'll again, we are just verifying that the method which we wrote is working fine or not by using different email IDs. You see that for the Sebas it is right click and after 5 seconds it will close. That's it, it's working fine for all this delete and no edit, all these things. You see that you made a helper method for edit and delete and simply you using this whenever you need. That's it, no need of writing all this logic again and again for each and every operation. Okay, and now tomorrow you have this kind of web table so many places as your application is having so many what web tables. So according to your web table this CSS will change. Even then also, instead of passing this one, what you can do while writing this helper method, you pass this CSS selector here and you pass this one also. Okay, you can do this one also. Then 1, 2, 3, if you pass these three, then single method is enough for multiple tables, right? Here I have only one table, this will never change. That is the reason I am hard-coded inside the code. If tomorrow you have multiple tables and each and every, it will change. And it will change. Which is changing, you just pass from here. Okay? Then it is easy. For each and every web table, you can use the same method. Shall we give a try? I'll take this and I'll copy paste again. I'll copy paste again and I'll change edit. I don't table row using email ID. I say email ID. Now what I'll do, string locator. Okay, string email. Right, how can I pass this? Okay, we need to think on that. So what I am doing here, string.format is one of the ways you can use to make it possible. We'll do one thing. We'll check this. If it is working fine, then we'll use the same logic there. Let it happen, whatever it happened. We are not bothered about this action. I am just checking that the string.format is working fine or not. Where it printed? Okay. String.format. I need to print this. Okay, is out GFG1. I'll give it a try again. The reason why I'm seeing is you need to make that string, we are appending position right in the edit icon, so that I am making very unique, so it will be very easy for you. Let it close. My company name is Geeks for Geeks. You see that? It is replacing here. So string.format, wherever you need to append dynamically, that can be mentioned as percentile s, means percentile string, then whichever you want to pass. So this one I am replacing here. We'll use the same logic here. Concatenation of two strings here, you see. So now we'll do the same thing. So here what I'll do, string email, and then string edit symbol, something like that. So while I'm calling this, I'm calling here, right? I'm calling here. So let it be. I'll write the logic here. Okay. What I need this much. I'll put it here. Then first I need locator, right? String locator is equals to, what is that? This one, right? This one I need to pass. So instead of directly passing here, I am putting in some variable and string email. What is that email ID I'm taking? I'll take it from here, some Sebas email. But here the challenge, string edit symbol is equals to string dot format. What is that format? We did this, right? We'll take from here. Is that possible to do? I think I need to pass as it is this one. I need to pass as it is. Okay. But position, how I can replace? So in that situation, you need to find the position before going to that. So for that, what it will do, you need to write one more method. What is that? Public static void get some position using that email ID. Okay. What is that? String email. So now you need to move this logic to here. Okay. String email. Then you'll get public static int. Okay, then I'll return that int, return position. Now here what I can do here, before getting that int position is equals to, I need to call this method getPosition, and I need to provide email, this email. Okay, now then edit symbol, how this edit symbol will work. Now I can use string.format, and this is this one, and here what I'll do, percentile s, okay, and this position I'll pass here. Now this will be replaced with this percentile s. Okay, how it is doing here, right? Now I can remove these things, it seems. The position will be replaced here with this percentile s. Now I need to change this. No. Get position. Control. Desired pencil icon. Now I don't need this one also, it seems. So what is that I am getting here? Edit symbol, right? String.format edit symbol I am getting. So this edit symbol, directly I can use. Okay. Am I using this locator? No. I don't need all these things, no. I made it two methods. Get position. In the get position, I can pass this CSS selector. Okay. String locator. This locator I can put here. I'll explain you again, as it seems some the previous methods we used is for only single table. These are for single table. Editor using email. But the logic way I'm writing is for all the tables it has to work. So get position, email. Here I need to pass locator. Right. This locator means in this list you find this email and get the position. Same logic. You see that? The same logic we broke into two methods. First I need to get the position. For that position I am passing the string locator and email ID. So I made it reverse here. First locator and then email. By replacing this e locator is this one. This replace it here and it will find all the elements in that. It will loop through, and by loop throughing this will take email and will get the position. Now I got the position. By taking that position I am building this, what you say, this one, this icon symbol I am building. You see that this is common for everything and this will change, right? That position I am passing from here. Okay, you can directly append, already I get the position, otherwise you can use string.format. Okay, in the edit table row using email ID, I need to pass only edit symbol. This edit symbol is enough. No, only one thing. So if I run this, it has to edit the sebas@email.com. I think it failed, it seems. The problem is invalid selector exception. We'll see in which location it is, the 89. Edit symbol. First I'll print this, whether it is giving perfect or not. If it is not giving, we'll move to the previous one. Very simple, I broke the method into two methods to make it very generic for all the tables. Just you pass these locators, then it will be easy for that to write. Otherwise, you can use the first way. You pass only email ID and you hard code all these things, then it will be easy for you. Again, it failed, but this time I need whether it is what it is printing. Okay, I'm getting this quotes also. Why quotes? Okay, this is what causing the issue. Okay, and it is perfectly printing by using string.format. You see that? And the nth child of 3, I need this 3, right? It's replacing. There is no error. Some extra quotes came. That is the reason it's failed. So this time it should work. Yeah, you see, it's working fine. Right, so that's what you need to do. These two methods are only I am sending the email ID, and these are all hard coding. But I broke these two methods. One is to get position, and there is to edit table using email ID. Here I am passing only this, and here I am passing these two. You pass these things for any table. You pass these two for any table, you will get the position, and you call this method using this edit symbol, means that icon which you formed here using this get position, right? And then if you need the same thing for phone, only this will change and this will change. You form all these things and you pass this to this one. Okay, this way you can handle web tables very easy. Okay, I made it very generic. For any table you can use. Okay, that's all in this video. Thank you.